And Chief Meteorologist Mark Finan is back to break down the river levels right now. So, Mark, what are you seeing?
Well, I'm going to show you a few different areas. Keep in mind that, you know, tonight we've had rain, but it's a cumulative effect that takes more of an impact on our area rivers. So there's always a delay before you see impact on rivers. And the bigger the river, the longer the delay. One of the ones that we're really keeping an eye on, let's start with this. This will be the Cosumnes River. This is at Michigan Bar. Now, this is as it's measured at Michigan Bar, which is out by Rancho Murrieta. This is where it is right now. And then this is the current forecast of where it goes tomorrow. This is up around 13.9 feet, something like that. So a little bit above flood stage. That red line right there is flood stage. And what that means is that farther downstream toward Wilton, we will likely see areas of high water. This is about 3 feet lower than what we saw back in January. January is up here, so now we're talking here. But either way, this would be good enough that we would see high water eventually on Saturday, get into Wilton, get into Twin Cities Road, Bruceville Road, Dillard Road, that sort of thing. We're likely to see standing water on Saturday. But also, look at the rest of this graph. It goes down, but then it goes back up. So that's the second atmospheric river that we're looking at. Let me show you one other one here. I want to call up the Tuolumne River that runs through Modesto, because this one is also going up. This one is a combination of the rain we're seeing as well as releases coming out of Don Pedro. So here's where we are right now, and this is what Josie was talking about. There are evacuations in place because of this peak that we're expecting above flood stage, and that's on Saturday afternoon. Looks like a relatively brief bump that we will see here, but there are a lot of communities there on the south side of the river. But also, this can impact the areas on the north side of the river by Dry Creek, which is on the south and east side of downtown Modesto. I want to show you Doppler radar too, just kind of give you an idea of what else is happening here, because all of this water coming up the west slope of the Sierra really impacts the communities on the west slope. Of course, that's our biggest watershed, but because of that, we're also starting to see releases come out of some of our bigger reservoirs on the west slope, and that will eventually have a bigger impact downstream. Let me show you another couple of rivers, and I'll call up the Feather River, because as of today, they're starting to do more releases out of Lake Oroville, and actually tomorrow they'll do a bigger release down the spillway. So here's where the Feather River is now in Marysville, and it's going up. Now this level is about 10 feet higher, and that'll be by the time we get into Monday. So a 10-foot rise, you'll notice that around the Marysville area and Yuba City. However, what you're also going to be seeing is that, well, this is still about 30 feet below flood stage. So while you're going to see a rise because of the releases they're doing out of Oroville, it'll only go up about 10 feet. Not that big a deal, but you'll notice it. Farther downstream, let's take a look at the Sacramento River at I Street. Here's where we stand right now. This is also scheduled to go up, and that by Saturday afternoon and into the day on Monday, it goes above monitor stage. So this rise here will impact places like Discovery Park, like we saw back in January. So even if we're not going to get to flood stage on areas like the Yuba River, the Feather River, or the Sacramento River, you are going to see a noticeable rise, due in part because of the rain we're seeing, but also due in part to releases that are being made from the bigger reservoirs. Back to you.